Hello everybody, today we are going to see our next point, that is from the circle non-collinear point. Okay, so from that first theorem is, which is very much important. See here, theorem number one, there is one and only one circle passing through three non-collinear points. Okay, first what is given here, non-collinear points. Okay, so everybody knows, I think, collinear points and non-collinear point. Collinear point means what? Points which are lying on the same line or straight line. Suppose point A is here, B is here and C is here. So we can say A, B, C are collinear. Okay, because they all the three points are on the straight line. So they are collinear. And non-collinear means opposite of this. So A, B and C, which are not on the same line. Okay, so like that here points are given, A, here B and here C, three non-collinear points are given. Okay, so got it everybody, what is the difference between collinear and non-collinear? Okay, so this is a activity in short. See what is given, there is one and only one circle passing through three non-collinear points. Okay, so we can construct only one circle which is passing through all the three points. Okay, so first here, given, what is given here? Given, there is one and one, only one circle passing through three non-collinear points. Three non-collinear points are given. Okay, so point A, point B and point C are non-collinear points means which are not on the straight line. Okay, so here these are the non-collinear points, understood? And we have to construct a circle which is passing through the all three points. Okay, and only one circle we can construct like that, that we need to prove here. Okay, so see here, first A, B and C, these three points are given. So first we need to do here, we will join this point A and B. Okay, point A and point B, B we will join. So you will get a straight line. Okay, then second we will join B and C. Point B and C. Okay, then after this we need to construct a perpendicular bisector of AB. Okay, so AB, everybody knows how to construct perpendicular bisector. So here we need to take more than half distance. Okay, AB, this is more than half distance we will take, and from this point we will make arc here. From the same point we need to take downside. Okay, with the help of same distance from point B we will make one arc, and downside here one arc. Okay, so here it is, both the arcs are not intersecting, so we can extend this. So here you will get this. Okay, so you will get here these two points when you will join. That time you will get a line which is bisecting AB. Okay, so here I am giving, this is a line, here I am giving a point A and this is point M. Okay, AM is bisecting here AB. Okay, so definitely this part and this part is equal, that is perpendicular bisector. The same way we need to construct perpendicular bisector for BC. Okay, so the same distance or more than half distance, we can change distance, or you can keep as it is, no problem, but it should be more than half distance. Okay, so here I am taking with the help of same distance. Now here I don't get here point, fixed point, so it is moving. But you will get exact point in the notebook. Okay, so here we need to join this point and this point. Okay, so here when you will join this, both the points, that time you will get an intersection point. intersection point, and that we will say that is O. Okay, so now if you will see here the distance between this, see OC from O to C, OC, then OB and OA distance is same, OA distance is same, okay. OC, OB and OA distance is same, means that is O is the center of circumcenter of these three points. Okay, so now you can construct a circle which is passing through the all the three points A, B and C. O is the center, OC or OB or OA is the radius of the circle, any one you can take because that is equidistant, O point is equidistant from A, B and C. So from that you can construct a circle. Okay, so you have to construct this. So now I am not doing that here, you have to do in notebook. Okay, so we will see now theorem. We will see proof. Okay, in proof there is theoretical part is more, so you have to refer textbook. Okay, it is given, only core part of this theorem I am showing here. See here, point what is given, point A, point B and point C are non-collinear points. Non-collinear point means which are not lying on the same line. Okay, so A, B, C are non-collinear points. What we have to prove? A circle passing through, to prove only one circle passing through non-collinear points A, B, C, A, B and C. Okay, so now we have done some construction, so that we need to mention here construction. Okay, so in construction what we have done, first join A, B, then B, C. Okay, so that will be our first thing. So join A, B and B, C and B, C. Okay, after that what we have done, okay, take a perpendicular bisector of AB, take perpendicular bisector or construct perpendicular bisector of AB, okay, that is perpendicular bisector of AB is here AB, here we will give PQ, that is P or PM, that is PM, intersecting AB at P, we will say this point P. Okay, the same way we need to take intersecting at P, same way we need to take perpendicular bisector of BC. Okay, so again construct perpendicular bisector of BC, okay, which will intersect BC at point, we will see here this is Y, okay, at point Y, understood. So now both bisectors will intersect each other at point O. Okay, at point O. Okay, so now we can see here, if you will join AO with the dotted lines, so I am joining here, okay, OA, and then we will join OB. Okay, same ways we will join here OC. Okay, so here we will mention join OA, OB and OC. Okay, so definitely see, this is the perpendicular, O is the point which is on the perpendicular bisector of AB. Okay, so definitely AO and OB are equal. Okay, so here we can write O is the point which is on the perpendicular bisector of perpendicular bisector of AB. So we can say AO is equal to OB. Okay, so for this point O, suppose O point is here, then to AO and OB are equal. Understood? So this is our first point. The same thing we will say, OB and OC also we have joined. So O is a point which is on the perpendicular bisector of BC. O is a point. O is also on the perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular bisector of BC. So we can say OB is equal to OC. OB is equal to OC. So this is our second point. Here see AO is equal to OB and OB is equal to OC. So from first and second we can say AO is equal to OB is equal to OC. Okay, so here we can say from first and second OA, OB and OC are equal. So now we can construct a circle which is passing through all the three points. Okay, so some more we need to write that I am telling you. Suppose this O point we will take here. Okay, O point suppose we will shift here, that I will say O dash. Understood? And intersection point is here. Then we cannot construct a circle which is passing through all the three points. Okay, so O dash and O should be same or super, it should be equal, then only one circle we can construct which is passing through all the three points. Understood? So here what is given? AO is equal to OB, OB is equal to OC. So AO is equal to OB is equal to OC. Got it everybody? So here construction is little bit more that we need to do. Okay, this theorem we have to take from the NCERT book. Okay, same theorem is given, little bit theoretical part is more, so you can understand that construction is important here and these two steps are important, but this theorem is important for class 10th also. So see carefully and do this theorem and solve this theorem in your notebook. Okay, we need to construct circle also. Okay, see here, our second theorem is theorem number 2, that is equal chords of a circle are equidistant from the center. Okay, once again see, figure is given, equal chords of a circle. Okay, actually figure we need to construct. Okay, equal chords of a circle, here see AB and CD are the chords and which are equal, that is given thing. Equal chords of a circle are equidistant from the center. Equidistant from the center. What is the center of this circle? Center is O. Okay. So what we have to prove here? We have to prove that these two chords are equidistant from the center. Means here we have to prove that the distance OM is equal to OL. That we need to prove. That is our target. Okay. So first we will mention here given things. What is given? Given in circle C O R. O is the center, R is the radius. Radius we have taken. Okay. So O R, chord AB is equal to chord CD. Okay. Chord AB and chord CD are equal. That is given. We have to prove that equal chords, the chords which are equal of a circle, are equidistant from the center. Of a circle is given. A circle means we have to use only one circle. Understood? The same condition can come for two circles also. Two circles are given and chords are equal. Okay? So like that also proof can come. Okay? So that also we can give proof. Okay? So here see, equal chords of a circle are equidistant from the center. So here we need to prove OM is equal to OL. Okay, this is our target that we need to prove. Okay, so now we need to do some construction. Okay, this is very easy to prove because if you will convert this into triangles, then that will be more easier way. Okay, so here see O and C. I will join this OC. Okay, then we can join this OA. Okay, so now we have two triangles. So first we will think about these two triangles, triangle OLA and triangle OMC. Okay, so that I am taking here. Construction, what we have done? Join OA and OC. Okay, we have done this construction newly. This much information was given. This we have done, so it should be mentioned in the construction. So join OA and OC. Okay, now next thing, proof. Last thing is proof. Okay, so we have two triangles. So first, triangle OAL and triangle OCM. Okay, so in triangle OAL and triangle OCM. Okay, OAL. So first we will think about this. How we can prove both the triangles are congruent. Okay. So see here, OA, first thing, OA and OC are the radii of the same circle. So OA is equal to OC. One thing we got. Second thing we can say, triangles are congruent. Angle is 90 degree. This angle is 90 degree. This angle is 90 degree. Why we can say? Because this is perpendicular drawn. Perpendicular drawn from the center of circle, bisect the chord. Okay, so this is drawn perpendicularly to AB and OM is perpendicular to CD. Okay, OM is perpendicular to CD. So that we need to mention. See, OM is perpendicular to AB. OL is perpendicular to AB. Okay, so perpendicular drawn from the center of circle bisects the chord. Okay, so definitely due to OL, AB is divided into two equal parts. So AL is equal to LB. So what we will say, we need AL because we are thinking about triangles. So we will think about a side which is the side of a triangle which we are using here. Okay, so AL is equal to half of AB. Okay, so AL is equal to half of AB, correct? AL is equal to half of AB. So, and AB and CD are equal. So, here AL is equal to half of AB, that is okay. So, now second thing we will see, OM is perpendicular to CD. OM is perpendicular to CD. OM is also perpendicular to CD. So, we can say CM is equal to half of DM. CM is equal to half of CD. Half of CD. This is our first, we will say this is our second. Okay. So, one thing we have, that is AB is equal to CD. AB is equal to CD, which is given. So, here we can write given. Okay. So, half of AB is equal to half of CD. Okay. If AB and CD are equal, then we can say half of AB is equal to half of CD. But half of AB means what? What is the value of half of AB is AL. So here we will replace by AL. Half of CD is equal to CM. So we will take here CM. Okay. So AL and CM. AL, CM is equal. AL is this and CM is this. So these two sides are equal. So this I am saying this is third one. Okay, so now we will think about these two triangles, triangle OAL and triangle OCM. Okay, so what is here? AO is equal to OC. AO is equal to CO. Why? What is the reason? AO and CO, why both are equal? Because radii of the same circle. Radii of the same circle. Okay, and radii of the same circle are always equal. So, AO and OC are equal. Second thing we have, just now we have AL is equal to CM. AL and CM is equal. So, here I can mention AL is equal to CM. What is the reason AL and CM, why they are equal? From third, here we have given. So, here we need to mention from third. Okay, so AL and CM are equal. Also, OMC angle, OMC is equal to OLA, angle OLA. Why? Because each 90 degree. Okay, both angles are 90 degree. So, now we need to think about criteria, which criteria we can use, or with the help of which criteria we can say both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so here see, we can use RHS criteria, because AO and OC are the hypotenuse of both the triangles, which are equal. Understood? Okay. And one side is equal. Any one side of the triangle is equal. And also both the triangles are right angle triangles. So here we can say triangle AOAL, triangle OAL, congruent triangle OCM, OCM by RHS. By RHS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, then we can say OM is equal to OL. So, we can say finally, OM is equal to OL. And that is our target. OM and OL are equal. So, here we got that. So, we need to write here reason by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay. So, OL and OM and OL are equal. Got it, everybody? So, here we got it. Okay, see here, our next theorem is chords of a circle which are equidistant from the center are equal, which are equidistant from the center are equal. Okay, so here see, figure is given. We can see the statement and figure. Chords of a circle which are equidistant means equidistant from the center means here what is given, OM and OL are equal, that is given. Okay, so this OM and this OL are equal because they have told us here this, these are the equidistant from the center are equal. What we have to show here, what we have to prove, AB and CD are equal, that we need to prove. So first given thing, given chords of a circle which are equidistant. Okay, in circle C O R, center is O, radius is R. Chords of a circle which are equidistant, what is given? OM, OM is equal to OL. This distance is given. Okay. If OM and OL are equal, then definitely OM is perpendicular to CD. OM is perpendicular to CD and OL is perpendicular to AB. Then only it is possible. Understood? If this OL, L is here, suppose this L is here, okay, and which is not perpendicular, then we cannot say this and this are equal. Okay, definitely both are unequal. So definitely this OL is perpendicular to, so here we need to consider that OL is perpendicular to AB. OL is perpendicular to AB and OM is perpendicular to CD. OM is perpendicular to CD. Okay. So, we have this. Now, we need to do some construction to prove. What we have to prove? To prove chords of a circle which are equidistant from the center are equal. Means here we have to prove chord AB is equal to chord CD. Okay. So, chord AB is equal to chord CD. Chord AB and CD are equal. Okay, so that is our target. So we need to do some construction for this. Construction, what construction we will do? We will join OC and OA. Okay, so join OC as well as OA. Join OC and OA. Okay. So, when you will join both OC and OA, that time two triangles are formed. Okay. So, triangle OAL and triangle OCM. Okay. So, now we need to prove, as usual, we need to prove both the triangles are congruent. Okay. So, see here. Here also we can say OC is equal to OA because they have the same circle and both are hypotenuse of both the triangles respectively. So, hypotenuse are equal. Okay. OL is equal to OM, which is given. OL and OM are equal, that is given. And third thing we have, that is OMC is equal to OLA, each 90 degree. So by RHS criteria, we can say both the triangles are congruent. So here see, in proof, in triangle OMC and triangle OLA, OLA, OMC and OLA OC is equal to OA. OC is equal to OA because radii of the same circle. Radii of the same circle. Okay. Then OM and OL are equal, which is given. OM is equal to OL. This is given. Okay, here it is given, circle which are equidistant from the center. Okay, and OMC angle, OMC is equal to angle OLA. Okay, each 90 degree, each 90 degree. Okay, if this angle is 90 degree, then only we can say OL is equal to OM. It is not given directly in the statement, that we have to consider with the help of given things. Okay, so OMC is equal to OLA each 90 degree. So by RHS criteria we can say triangle OMC congruent triangle OLA by RHS, right hand side. Okay, if triangles are congruent, then we can say, here I am taking now, if triangles are congruent, here we can say AL is equal to CM. AL is equal to CM. Okay, so here I am saying this is by CPCT. CPCT, this is I am saying first one. Okay, now actually this is not our target. Our target is different. AB is equal to CD, we need to prove. Okay, so now we can say OL is perpendicular to AB. OL is perpendicular to AB. And we know that a perpendicular drawn from the center of circle bisect the chord. Perpendicular drawn from the center, bisect the chord. AL is equal to CM. So AL is equal to what? AL is equal to half of AB. AL is equal to half of AB. And CM is equal to what? Half of CD. Half of CD. Okay. So half will be cancelled. Then what we will get? AB is equal to CD. So chord AB is equal to chord CD. And that is our target. Okay, so this way we can give proof for the same. Got it? So today we have seen three theorems. So see carefully, very much important theorems we have seen, and very easy theorems are there. Okay, so do the practice of same theorems in your notebook. Thank you very much.